students, welcome to our online class. At present, I am in 8th standard social study class. In the previous class, we had a discussion about the nice concept about the soils of Karnataka. We already completed in the previous class, red soil. Now, it is the time to understand the both very important soils of Karnataka. Those are known under the black soil and laterite soil. Here, it is information about the black soil. For what reason? This soil is in the black color. There is a reason. This kind of soil is formed by the weathering of basalt rocks. Basalt rocks are the main causes to create like this colorful soil, that is black soil. So it is rich in aluminium. The major quality of black soil is it is very rich in aluminium. The next point is that magnesium and oxides of iron. Here black soil contain three major points or things. The very first one, black soil is very rich in aluminium, magnesium and oxides of iron. That's why it is in a black color. So we have to consider it is in a black color. So next one, it is also called black cotton soil. It is also called black cotton soil. For what reason this is considered as a black cotton soil? There is a reason. The crop of cotton, very much we are growing in the soil of black soil. That's why it is considered as the black cotton soil. Understand? The next point is that this soil has the ability to retain moisture for many days. That is the capacity of black soil. What is the capacity of black soil? Here, this soil has the ability to retain moisture for many days. And since it is rich in soil nutrients, it is also moisture retention power, and also it is very rich in nutrients, and a variety of crops can be grown in this black soil. What are the important crops we have to grow in the black soil? The very first one is that cotton, jowar, then cotton, jowar, maize, sunflower and chili, paddy, pulses and oilseed. These are the major important crops we have to grow in the black soil. Once again I repeat that, which are the important crops of black soil? The very first one, cotton, jowar, maize, sunflower, chili, paddy and pulses and also onion. These are the major crops we have to grow in the black soil. And which of the important districts contain or occupying the black soil? Here, the very first one is that North Karnataka, especially North Karnataka is considered as it is a Deccan trap. Deccan trap means the more area having this black soil. Which are the northern district, North Karnataka districts are there? One is Dharwad, Gadag, Ballari, Koppala and Kalaburgi, Yadagiri, Bagalkota, Belagavi and Chitradurga. These northern Karnataka district having more black soil. That's why the North Karnataka of Karnataka state is considered as Deccan trap of India. Is it clear? The next point we have to understand there, that is laterite soil. Laterite soil here, this kind of soil is found in areas which receive heavy rainfall and heavy temperature. Where we have to find out the very high temperature, in that area we have to find out the like this laterite soil. The next point we have to understand here, water, stubble, lime and silicates dissolved in this soil. Here the capacity, what is the capacity of laterite soil? The laterite soil capacity is water, salt and lime and silicates dissolved in rainwater. And settle down in the lower layers. When the rain is falling at the time, the lateral soil retention power is not there. That's why this lateral soil totally silicate dissolved the entire rainwater. The next point we have to understand, iron and aluminium, which are unassembled, remain in the top layers. That's why the soil became soft during the rainy season. This is the major quality of lateral soil. It is very smooth and it is very soft during the rainy season. Dries up in the summer season. This rock is used for construction purpose, and major important crops are there. Which of the crops we have to grow in this laterite soil? The very first one is cashew. The second one is coffee, tea, cardamom, pepper, rubber, coconut. These are the commercial crops we have to grow in the laterite soil. Is it clear? The next point we have to understand, which are the prominent districts we have to find out like this laterite soil. Here the very first district is there, that is Uttar Kannada, Udupi, Dakshina Kannada, and Kodagu, Chikkamagaluru, Shivamogga, and Belagavi have more rainfall area having this laterite soil. So in this way we have to understand about black soil and laterite soil information. In the next period we have to understand alluvial soil along with the natural vegetation. We have to discuss in the next class. Okay, thank you.